Hello, Commander.
Because I do like the idea that there's such few creeps, which makes creeping very valuable. But at the same time, on a map like this, on a map like Salai, and by the way, rest in peace, eye users. It's so bright. Oh God, it's so bright. You lower your bright your you lower your settings. It gets brighter. I don't know why. We're playing on medium, and this is killing me in the eyeballs. So yeah, if you are playing in the dark, I would really suggest you turn on a light. That way you don't go blind, because you will go blind on a map like this, because your settings are lower. Seriously, I crap you now. Crap you not. All right. Scouting hounds just saying hi to each other, kind of doing the basic stuff. The biggest thing to note is we do, like I said, we have creeps to the north, big radioactive scorpion in the middle, and creeps to the south, and that's about it. You can do some like harassment to your opponent's worker line if you want to be a funny little joke, but you're not really gonna do much else. That's about it. There are some natural expansions. Again, like I feel like putting creeps here, maybe putting creeps here, you know, like in these little corners, just so that yes, it's important to grab these middle creeps and stuff, but I feel like it's I don't know. I don't know. Maybe I'm complaining and I'm just not adapting to the map style, because obviously this is a 1v1 map. This is a much more player fighting kind of map. You're not this isn't like World of Warcraft where you have to or Warcraft, excuse me, where you have to level everything up perfectly. But I didn't even introduce our heroes, our players. Spawning on the left side, currently up, I believe, two maps. I might be going crazy. I might be wrong. We in the blue trunks, it is Scaffs. Currently up. What are we looking at here? He's currently up at least one map against his opponent, who is in the red trunks. It is Squidfighter, one of the developers for Pathos Gaming, literally the guys who made the game. Now we do have Lady Vanya coming out. I think Squidfighter going back to his roots. He's a very good Lady Vanya player. Or we're gonna call her LV for the rest of the game for any of you that are curious or confused. And it is an LK or Lord Karthor for Scaffs. And good Q, that lifesteal is I think was still going on. Windwalk also coming out, which is kind of weird. At level one, you get two abilities, but whatever. Good chip damage. 240 214 versus it's about even. Actually, I think Lee go. Oh, did he just deny the Kobe? Yeah, I think he did. Okay. One last Q just to kind of rile his jimmies. But they're pretty much just kind of dancing with each other right now, not really doing too much. Just waiting until the Jester and the first couple of footmen come out. Jester first here for blue. A bit of a hero or a unit choice here, as it is going to be a knight, a footman first, excuse me, from red. So it looks like they're both going to kind of just let each other creep a little bit, and then it's going to be the battle of the Rad Scorpion. So we'll have to see what the decision is here. Jester, very easy at creeping. Let me tell you what. Zoop zop beep de boop. There goes that guy's health. And some life stealing from Karthor is going to make creeping, like I said, very easy. Creeping on both sides, very easy, especially with two extra knights. And now they're pretty much going to start trading blows again as they, well, actually. Oh, a little bit of greed? No. He looks like he just wanted to face check it, realizing that Karthor isn't here right now. Is gonna try and target down. Ah, the Jester in the back. So good. Look at this damage. Bam. Bam. Look at all that damage just being done solely by the Jester by himself. And this is big. This is really big because Blue is respecting the giant scorpion take. It's a level 4 Lady Vanya now against a level 2 Lord Karthor. And essentially, this means that there's going to be one ultimate shot fired here and no CC. Oop. There's a good Q. Windwalked out of it. Jester gonna continue to try and target down. Lady Vanya is completely noping out of there. Hello? Okay, that's game. Very, very bizarre engagement. I don't know why, like, cool guys don't look at explosions. I mean, Lord Karthor did die. That's great. I don't think she even got that experience, though, because she wasn't even there to get it. Oh, the quick trick stabs! The trick stabs! And one more shot, one more shot. Money. So that is a level 4.5, let's say. LV. He was going to be very easily to take that. Real quick, let's take a look at the buildings. We've got 3 houses, 2 camps for Squid Fighter, or 2 training camps, and then we have 3 houses and 4 training camps here from Scaffs, so very aggressive on that. And we have a scout dog just looking for an expansion. Grabbed the creeps, which is perfect. This is not up just yet, just because, well, it was murdered recently. I believe it actually takes 2 full minutes to get the scorpion back up, which it's crazy, especially in these like very quick time maps. 2 minutes is a long time. It is a very long time. Hello, shh, no one tell him. Where are you going?
What do you want?
Hello? All right, well, that's a good find. This is going to be a very easy kill. I don't think Lord Carthor is... He's being trained right now. You can tell by the fires of the torch. But this is an easy base kill, and... Yeah, that's there really isn't much that this Jester squad can do. They can try and target it down. They're going to try and save the base. But these knights are just doing way too much. And I think, yeah, Blue realizes it's just not worth trying to throw these units away at this point. So level 5 Lady Vanya versus a level 2 Lord Carthor. And again, he does not have that CC, which is so important. It is so important because all LV has to do is just walk up, pop the chain stun, and then just target fire. And as long as he doesn't lose, yeah, there you go. Tons of solid CC. Can pop the Q onto LK. Nope, just wanted to go after one of the footies, understandably. But again, look at this. He won't be getting any of the XP that he needs to get to level 3. And yep, he's gonna go straight back onto that scorpion. Great idea. Getting plenty of damage done on this. And that should give her probably 6.5, maybe 7? 6.5, okay. So there we go. Again, the Scout Hound from Blue realizing, oh, here we go. I don't know if he saw that expansion or not. He's going for the expansion, but he wants to do it while he's in a commanding position, which is exactly when you should expand. Expand when you're ahead. That way you can secure the lead. This will give Carthor level 3, but look at the army count. It's 3, 6, and a couple of Jesters, 9, versus all of that. No Jesters in Red's army, so it's not... It's a pretty basic army, to say the least. It's a very basic army.
Yes, my lord.
No tech so far. No, there is a blacksmith, which is about to get level 1 and level 2 on its way. Very important. No blood rush on these guys, so it's a very basic army as well. Now, oh, he could have caught... Oh, he might catch this army. He's going to see the hero. Could Q. Does Q. Now he's just very afraid. Wow, look at that. He actually windwalked away. You can tell how worried this... Lord Carthor is when compared to the army that Red currently has. And yeah, this is a great time to expand for Red. Not trying to push, just getting that nice soft contain. Just wants to hold down the fort, make sure Blue can't expand, because soon he's gonna be out of lumber, and you gotta expand if you want to win, man. So Squid Fighter's taking the advantage, just gonna get a ton of workers out, and we should see. Gotta be careful about the rallying, because the footies will push Lord Carthor into death. So you have to be very careful about that. Jester coming out, so we might see a target fire here. We'll have to see. Blacksmith is getting weapons 1. We do have blood rush for the footmen, but we do not have the armor 1 that these footmen do have, and the blood. Yeah, so it's blood rush armor versus blood rush melee, or soon to be blood rush melee. Hello. Weird flex, but okay. Did he build 2 of them? Yeah, he did. Okay. Weird engagement, but multi-shot did nothing. That multi-shot completely whiffed. There are so many footmen still alive, though, for Blue. Jester's completely targeting down Lady Vanya. She has to scatter or pop the Q on it, but there's just so many red footmen. It's kind of evened out. Lord Carthor has had a great opportunity to try and get this down, but the Jester's doing such a great job at zoning Lady Vanya. She's gone. She's completely gone. These footmen this footman army has been completely cleaned up. And now it is on LK to try and regain the position and try and stop this expansion from getting fully operational. He's already checking. He's going straight for the expansions. LV should be fully aware. Oh, this is the problem last time that killed him. This is the problem that killed. It's way too late. It is way too late. I feel like just... Ooh. There was he. Did you guys see a hero here? Was there a hero here earlier? I don't remember there being a hero. I don't know. Maybe LV was alive. This is gonna die. That's free kills for... He's gonna try and keep the boys. Nope, they're gonna just rally and die. That sucks. A lot of easy XP for LK. Not going after any of the temples, which is kind of interesting. I feel like this was such a big throw. This was such a big throw. I mean, I know it's important to get them to try and break the sieges, but you can get catapults for that, brother. You can get crows to scout for that. This was such a throw. He was in a very solid position. But those jesters just zoned Lady Vanya so hard. I mean, that was a great call. That was a great call by Scaff. And there goes the nature power. So it is Blood Rush 1-1 footman versus quite a few knights and just 1-0. So it is now on Scaffs to try and break the turtle of Squidfighter. Lady Vanya is being trained right now, but is not on the field just yet. And let's see. I really like the jester play. I don't know. I really like that.
Excuse me.
3-6. Wow, that is a... Okay, big accompaniment. Big accompaniment of jesters, actually. I was about to try and do a base check real quick. Lady Vanya gets the Q. Windwalk in. Ooh, good save on the shout. Didn't really want to try and engage on it. Scaffs is currently in the process of expanding. I think she just tried to shoot her frost arrow, but it didn't actually connect for some reason. Gonna back up into the hero's throne. Just want to try and get a little bit of bonus damage if he can. But yeah, Scaff's playing the smart man's game, and he's just gonna back up and expand. As guess what? Someone's about to run out of expansion money, and once you do that, it's game. Jester didn't really rally or path the right way that he needed to, and ironically enough, okay, never mind. I was about to say the scorpion is gonna do a pretty good job at just killing off a couple of the units. Hello? Hello? Did he just get free level 7 for... Okay, targeting down Lord Carthur. It's not going to do it. He's just going to pop his screen. There we go. And there goes all of Red's units. This should be a complete rout here from Red. And that should be game. Triple Jester teleport. Forget your units. Was it me or was there like two scorpions that just free spawned for blue for no reason? That's so bizarre. Alright, so Lady Vanya is going to try and kill off a significantly larger army than her own. I like the knight. I praise be to the knights. This is how you counter him. Perfume Cloud, though, is going to do a great job at kind of closing the gap that blue was trying to have. This is it, boys. I don't know how much resources he has left, but this is going to come in. Knight is still up. He's going to be the linchpin for this entire army. There are spearmen still alive, but jesters can target down knights pretty darn easy. Oh my god, the hammer. Respect the hammer, son. One knight versus the world. That cleave damage is god tier. And here comes the boys are being pulled. The knight does go down. There are still two spearmen and two footsies alive, and he's actually going to long distance mine. Doesn't even have the resources to expand. He could queue this. Oh god, the boys. Hang on, boys. Hang on. I don't know if he has enough resources to queue to try and just lock him in place so the footmen can, or the workers can try and get it. Gets level 8 at the like most opportune time, is going to lifesteal away on the villagers, and he's going to keep his hero alive for just a little bit longer. And the spearmen are now going to buffer for blue, and that's it. Wow, that was close. Pendulum of momentum all the way up to here for red. And then as soon as it broke, it... Jesus. As soon as it broke, that was pretty much game.